busy. I'm not here to chit. Forging a weapon strengthens it. And ores are transmogrified spirits. Their presence blesses the weapon. Ores are transmogrified. All done. Blacksmith.
I can forge weapons for you.
Well, Ed's still up to his old ways, is he?
Even the demons don't know what to do with him, hmm? God, a side's ache. Back in my younger years, I had the strength of an ox. The miners would always ask me to clear out the bear bugs, which I pummeled with my bare hands. But even I couldn't beat them. So, I lobbed them into the lava pits. I'm pretty strong myself. But even I don't compare to Ed. He's a beast, I tell you. A man must eat dragon tails and wrestle stones. If you heed my advice, you'll avoid crossing him. I reckon he'd prove a lot more trouble than most demons. Deep inside Stonefang Mine is an ancient dragon burial ground. The bones of the dragons exude ore. Deep inside stone bones of the dragons. You come back alive.
I was worried sick. Sages and all manner of wise men watch over the halls of this nexus. This rejuvenating sanctum is a fine place for the slayers of demons to rest their weary bones. I too must contribute how I can, for we are indebted to our honorable defenders. I too must contribute how I can. We are indebted.
Back in the time that I lived below Bolotaria Castle, King Alant left on some strange business, then returned with horrible demons in tow. Soon, the land was ravaged by soul-starved madmen. My spine shudders just to think about it. If I did not have my miracle stone shard, keepsake of my grandfather, I may not have survived. Have you heard? If you are attacked by a demon, you will lose your humanity. What a horrible thought. Just what would happen then? I simply cannot fathom it. Mbasa. My grandfather had unusual tastes. He often visited Stonefang Mine, where he collected rocks of all shapes and sizes. Most of them had no value, but among them, he found a miracle stone shard, which he gave to me. Could this, too, be a sign from God? But among them, could this, too?
I have sinned.
I swore allegiance to Saint Urbain, but was of no use to him. And now,
I have run away and abandoned his augustness. O Lord, for I have not the strength to punish myself. O August One, I hesitate to imagine your presence
deep within the darkness,
where no light shall ever shine.
Will you continue to pray, even in such misery?
O August Deep, will you continue to pray?
Oh, you must be another disciple of God. I too am on a quest to fight the demons in the name of the Lord. May I share God's power with you? Do not be bashful. We are both cut from the same cloth. miracle is a heavenly act, but spells are the acts of demons, the work of soul arts. They have similar effects, and yet one is clearly evil, and the other is clearly good. Magicians, in the end, are mere servants of the demons. A miracle is a heavenly act. They have magicians in the end. I see. Today we meet again.
Have you met the last surviving monument? Those fools revived the old one on a whim. And now they've trapped us here in the Nexus in a desperate attempt to undo their mistake. It's all a travesty, if you ask me. Well, you found yourself a demon soul, did you? I'm impressed. Yes, indeed I am. Stay the path, and you will soon be a monster yourself. Can't you see? You've fallen for their trap. You. Have you seen my corporeal flesh? Has my body gone rotten? I'm sorry. Please, leave me alone.
What do you want, brute? I have no use for addlepates like yourself. Away with you. What do you want? I have no use for...
Before the Blight, Boletaria was a grand kingdom. The king, his knights, and his subjects were modest and plain, but also steadfast and compassionate. I have spent much time in my studies in the cultured countries of the south, yet no country holds my heart as does Boletaria. But look at what has become of us now. I refuse to believe that this is what Father wished for our great land. Here in Boletaria, we speak of the legend of the two swords and the solitary hero. The two swords are Demonbrand and Soulbrand. One sword banishes that which befouls man, and the other banishes man himself. The solitary hero is Old King Doran. King Doran is the Everlasting One, founder of Boletaria and protector of the two swords. Of course, only according to legend. But in the dark state of our land, sometimes legends are all we have. King Alant led Boletaria with a round table of the bravest knights. The noble twin fangs, Valifax and Bjor. Alfred, the tower knight. Metas, the penetrator. And the brave tribesman, Longbow Ulan, and his fearsome legions. But today, Boletaria is an abysmal mess. Valifax was lost, and Bjor slipped through the fissure, never to be heard from again. All the rest, along with Boletaria, are either devoured by the fog or fallen afoul of the demons. The Boletarian knights are no longer. But perhaps our age will see the rise of new heroes, such as yourself. But perhaps our age will see the rise of new heroes.
Thou seekest the power of the soul, then touch the demon inside me. Soul of the mind, key to life's ether. Soul of the lost, withdrawn from its vessel. Let strength be granted so the world might be mended. So the world might be mended. Art thou fin? May thy strength help the world.